we're lucky to have two different vaccines that have just been approved by emergency use. Both of them are very safe. We do want people to know that they will have what we call an immune response. Some people refer to this as side effects, but I like to think about it as your immune system actually kicking in and responding to the vaccine. So some people will have fatigue, muscle aches, some people have fevers, and that's to be expected. Most of these are short-lived, so they'll last for 12 to 24 hours. And after that, you really start to build up your immunity, which is great news. They both have very similar profiles in terms of immune responses. They both are very efficacious. They both are very good at preventing people getting COVID. So in terms, when people ask me which vaccine, you know, I would prefer, I would say whichever one is available. The main myths that I've heard are, one, can I get COVID from the vaccine? And the answer is no, thankfully. The vaccine is not live and doesn't contain anything else other than just one little protein in COVID. So we can put that one aside. The other myth is whether, you know, it works on people who might have suppressed immune systems or people who come from, you know, diverse communities or communities that are significantly impacted by COVID. And thankfully, actually, a lot of those communities were represented in the studies of the vaccine. And so I would say the vaccine is effective for essentially all, you know, patient groups, regardless of, you know, skin color or what you look like. I think a lot of people are just concerned that it's new or that there's not enough safety data. I hear that a lot. And I would say from my perspective, again, I would just reassure people that safety was not done at warp speed. It was really been a rigorous process. And we, you know, in this vaccine clinic, we have a lot of safety protocols in place to continue to follow people to make sure that they're not experiencing additional side effects. So from the safety part of it, I feel very, very confident. I think this is, you know, the beginning of an exit strategy. And, you know, even after you get the vaccine, it still takes several weeks to build up your immune response. And we're still learning a little bit more about, even if I'm vaccinated, is it still possible to have small bits of the virus that I could actually transmit to somebody else? And those are questions we don't know the answer to. So for all of those reasons, we will still be masking and gowning and gloving and doing lots of hand hygiene and taking all the precautions in the community that we need to make sure that people aren't getting COVID.